my friends in.
Hi, how are you?
They're gonna tell us how we gotta go through the process. They got those good veins too, just like me.
You're gonna be first, so that way you know. That's all right.
That's you.
Yes, sir, that's me.
How long they usually take? You guys can see it like in a day or 2 days?
Which one?
What test? The results.
It just depends what test. Within 24 hours.
That's what I mean.
Yeah. Majority. And then we have the app, so I literally pull on my phone maybe in 12 hours. After midnight, I'll get the CMP back and all that. So, all right. So right now I'm getting stuck right now with a butterfly needle. And Pablo's the awesomest at it. So he just inserted in my vein. He's going to take the blood right now. And you're going to notice... How many vials of blood Pablo's gonna take? Four vials. And he's gonna take these vials because of all the tests we're running, okay? And it's a good amount of tests, and it's gonna test for a lot of different things, like liver, kidneys, electrolytes. It's gonna test for blood cell counts.
On the diabetic too, A1C.
Hemoglobin A1C, yep. Hemoglobin A1C is a 3 month average of your sugar levels. Mm-hmm. So at that point it can tell you if you're pre-diabetic, diabetic, and this should be a big red flag and awareness point for you guys because of our diet in the United States and all the sugar that we intake, especially our kids. If you notice the rates of diabetes in our country, it has raised hundreds of percent. I think it's 200 or 300% almost. It's something ridiculous. So at that point, you want to be preventative. You want to make sure that your body is not going through this and getting high sugar levels because it's a silent killer. It's gonna hurt you along the way. You're not gonna feel it at first, but in long term, it's going to kill you. Awesome, thank you, that's me. He's just verifying that that's my blood that he's putting on there. And guys, we use the most professional labs in the United States. And the reason we do this is because that's all they do, that's what they're good at. I've seen some labs, to be honest with you, they've drawn blood, and the girl must have been new. She draw three people's blood. She didn't put the sticker on there right away. Put their blood, lined up, left, came back. Whose blood is that? Whose blood is it? I guess I'll just stick it on here. So at that point, you know, you always want to make sure you check your results. You want to make sure you're going to a professional lab.
Who wants to go, Lee or Kevin?
When you get your lab results back, you should always get a copy of lab results. So your lab results are going to be key, and what it's going to do is it's going to track your progress in your body. So no matter if you have your lab results from your primary care physician, your hormone replacement therapy physician, or whoever it may be, keep your results, keep them in a folder, and keep them in chronological order. That way you can track through time what's been going on in your body and what's been going on in these ranges. At that point, if you have a problem, you can have that doctor have a really clear picture of what's going on instead of you guessing and telling him you think, this is what I think it was and this is what I think it was. Instead of that, he can look at it, it's a full picture. At that point, he can give you some really good answers of what's gonna do, or at least some sort of idea, you know? Especially with hormones, you definitely wanna track your hormones. At that point, you can see where you're at. I think once you dial in, especially on HRT, like as far as testosterone replacement therapy, as long as you're not going crazy or doing anything dumb, you can pretty much dial yourself in. At that point, we do with patients within the first 6 months at least. Usually it's within the first three. At that point, they're dialed in, they've got their dosages, and they're just on track, and they're just being consistent with what they're doing. I think that's the next thing, is consistency. Because if you don't have consistency in what you're doing, you're really setting yourself up for failure. The reason you're setting yourself up for failure is you're not being consistent, you're not doing these things every day. So maybe not even, you know, every day. So the example that I want to give is okay, you find out you have low testosterone, you get your testosterone replacement therapy package. At that point, you're not consistent or not doing the dosages or the medication like they were properly prescribed to you. What you're doing is you're throwing yourself off and you're throwing your body off. Now you're guessing on what you should do next. Is it, should I take more of an estrogen blocker? Should I take more testosterone? Should I lower my dose of testosterone? You know, where am I really at? If you're taking your starting off dose therapy or your regimen and you think something's off, whether it be us or somewhere else, the first thing you should do is call them and let them know. Let the medical provider know what the concerns are, what you think is going on. They may have already faced that battle and can tell you some answers, or they should be sending you in for blood work and testing for some of these symptoms that you're talking about, whether it be sensitive nipples, whether it be no erections, whether it be water retention, all these different things. It's really, really key to look at.
Do you what do you do for water retention?
So water retention, you want to look at what's going on, right? So for guys, the big thing is, the big symptom is water retention is usually high estrogen levels.
Okay.
So at that point, yeah. So when guys, the biggest thing is I don't need an aromatase inhibitor. I do not need one.
Okay.
Bo told me, this doctor says I don't need one. He's just prescribing testosterone. The first thing I tell them is, hey, listen, I'll do a Pepsi challenge with you. $25. Let's test your estradiol levels, which is E2, right?
Okay.
If it's high, you pay for the test. If it's low, I'll pay for the test, right? But at that point, it will go there. They're so hard-headed, they don't want to pay the $25 up front. But if I say I'll pay for it, then they're ready to test it. And then when they see the number come back high, like, oh, man. And then they correct it.
Okay.
Their results are going to be better. They're going to look better. They're going to feel better. So, I mean, that's really what it's about. I mean, you know, dialing them in. You know, these are regular people, so they're dialing them in, they're on that dose, and they're feeling good, and they're not getting any symptoms or very minimal symptoms of what it is. So, I mean, that's kind of what it is. I mean, there's a big debate now. It just came up. The big thing with an HRT was you know, these doctors know that we're going to need an aromatase inhibitor, we need testosterone, and most of them ACG. So now some of these doctors are going rogue, and they're saying, listen, no aromatase inhibitor. But my thing is that when you test estradiol levels and they go up and they're way over range, you're gonna have problems. There are studies done on high estrogen levels and what it can cause. So high blood pressure, I mean, there's a lot of different things. So at that point, with high estrogen levels too, usually the male's more moody. The common mistake is, or myth, is that testosterone creates roid rage. That's not true. Testosterone puts you in a good mood usually. Now, it can make you a little bit more aggressive, I guess, in situations where you need to be. But the usual culprit of that is high estrogen levels. High estrogen levels make you like the grumpy old man effect. You're irritable, and what you can like look as an example, it's the same thing with men and females. So if females go through their period, what happens?
And generally they get grumpier.
Water retention, bloating,
yeah.
Irritability.
Okay.
These are all things with high estrogen levels or fluctuation hormones. Same thing. Just like testosterone for guys and females, it creates, you know, you have a libido effect. You get more lean muscle mass. I mean, it is what it is. The only difference is the ranges that we have. So we know a testosterone range for males is going to be higher because that's a masculine hormone.
Yeah.
Where estrogen is a female, it is. So at that point, you know, it's pretty simple when you look at it. I mean, it's not that complicated. I mean, it is. No, don't get me wrong. This is complicated. I'm not saying it like that, but I'm just looking at the simplicity of, hey, listen,
that's
guys and girls both have the same hormones.
Yeah.
The exact same negative side effects happen, and they both get, you know, whatever happens from that side effect, whether it be water retention, irritability, or lean muscle mass, or whatever it may be from testosterone, libido effect. I mean, usually females, if they have really low testosterone levels or libidos in the dirt, right? They can't, you know, get any lean muscle mass. They can't get their weight off. They hit that brick wall. So, I mean, if that's, you know, that's not optimal, then that's what it is. Now, you know, taking too much masculine hormone for a female can cause masculine traits. So at that point, you know, you got to make sure you're dialed in. And at that point, it is what it is. And people do what they want to do, and they're going to do what they want to do with their body. But you always want to look at that. So whatever you're looking to get at, feel-wise, look-wise, probably should go to a medical practitioner, somebody who knows what they're talking about, or at least been through the experiences to tell you what you should be doing. And always do blood work, no matter what anybody says. No matter what a doctor says, coach says, bro says, family member says. Seriously, I mean, even me, don't listen to what I have to say, do blood work. And at that point, you can see at least, hey, listen, this is what's going on. So, yeah, it's key. I'm anxious to see where Kevin's lab work comes back.
Why?
Because he's such a specimen. I mean, you know,
Such a specimen.
Seriously, he's such a specimen. I'd love to see lab work like this. It's good, you know?
Yeah. Well, I'm interested to see as well.
All right, very nice.
Conference.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, guys.